Okay, good morning. Now we discuss about transient thermal analysis. So what is the difference between thermal and transient? So in steady state thermal analysis, we does not consider any time. Whereas in transient thermal analysis, we should consider time. Okay. So these problems are mostly used in analyzing in furnace when pouring after pouring the furnace, after pouring the metal into the from the furnace, the metal should be liquid state until it reaches the end of the cavity. It collect the the metal is collected from furnace and it will pouring to molding box, molded area until it should be in liquid form. Okay. So that cases, and also in fins. Do you know about fins? Fins means heat transfer in our two wheeler in our automobile. Okay, so there we can use it, but here it is a fin. So we will do 3D model. It's a fin. It's a 3D. It is a volume. So how to make volume? You should know it. So you see the drawing. Left side 170 degrees Celsius temperature. Around the metal, convection rate is convection. The heat transfer is through convection. And here, instead of temperature, here the heat generation is given. Okay, as it is, preference, thermal, preprocessor, element type, add, solid. Under brick, okay, because it is a 3D model, so under brick, lower version, so 8 node plane 70, okay, close. Then we need not make a material properties, material model, thermal conductivity, isotropic, given conductivity is given 0.17, okay. Then modeling, create. Volume, okay, volume, cylinder, solid cylinder, x0, y0, radius given 1 unit, length given 10 centimeter, I think 10 centimeter, so depth, it's called depth, okay, then the cylinder will shows like this, you can turn the cylinder like this, okay, then you want to mess, after create the modeling, you're going to mess it, mesh tool, smart size, mesh, thickard. Okay, ignore this command. Then we are going to give loads. Okay, loads, define loads, apply thermal temperature on area. But in 2D model, online, here 3D model, you can give the load on area. You say okay. Temperature 170 degree, right? Then next convection around the cylinder. So convection on areas, you pick two areas. You can see, you can count, you can see here there is a two count. You ensure that it should be two count. Okay, then you okay. So coefficient is given, convection coefficient is given. Yeah, 0.0025, temperature is 25. Say okay. Then you can use Y direction. You can hear Y direction is there. You can rotate the cylinder into this. It should be visible this side. Then here, instead of temperature, they are given heat generation on area. So it's given the value. Heat generation is 0.0625. Say okay. Now messing is over. Load option is over. So how it will differ from steady state transient means it give they use time. The temperature from here, the 100 degree temperature, it will flow from here to here. It will take the time. 50 second is 50 second, the time taken to heat the transfer the heat from this side to this side 50 seconds. Okay, it also given. Okay, so how we will assign? Go to solution analysis type. You should change six place. You should change you make some changes. Okay, so first change analysis type, new analysis, default as steady state to go. You should change into transient. That is first. Then full solution. We want to make full analysis. Then next, solution control, solution option. Here we need the result. We need a solution every sub step. So here you can see every sub step is there. Yeah, write every sub step. So second, again, load step option. Go to load step option, output control, solution printout. We need printout in every sub step. Okay, then database result file. That's also every sub step. Four, then time frequency, time to time step. They are given 50 second. The time taken from one side to another side, the time taken to transfer the temperature from one side to another side is 50 second. The step, we can give the step 5 second, every 5 second. We need the result every 5 second. Okay, then you should make automatic stepping on, because if our given data is somewhat error, it will take automatically. Okay, then you know about ramp and stepped. Stepped means maybe if you click stepped, you can get 5, 10, 20 result, seconds results. Whereas the ramp, in ramped, you can get 7 seconds also. Okay, then say okay. Yes. Yeah, it's okay. Now the pre-processing is over. Now directly go to solve current load step. Okay. It will take some time. If you give more than if you give steps, number of steps is high, then the time also high. Now you can get the result solution down. Okay, then go to general post processor. As usual, plot result, contour plot, nodal solution, DOF solution, nodal temperature. Say okay. It shows the nodal temperature, maximum temperature. And you can also find thermal gradient. Thermal gradient is nothing but QT by QX. QT means time, temperature with respect to distance. Thermal gradient means QT by the difference heat of QT, temperature with respect to time, distance. Okay, any component, X component, you can find the extra X component also. Then again go to nodal, you can note these values, and again go to nodal solution, thermal flux. Thermal flux means dq by ds, time, temperature with respect to time. Thermal flux or heat flux. Okay, so that also you can. Okay, now it's okay. Now as usual, go to plot result, counter plot, nodal solution, nodal temperature. Okay, I already told you that you can find the temperature wherever you want. So for example, I need temperature here. This is the maximum temperature here, 170, but here what is the temperature here? It will come to 75 degrees. It reduced to 75 because here we have the data is heat, in terms of heat generation, but we there is no data for temperature. So that is, you should find out the temperature here, 75. 170 is due to convection, it was reduced into 75. You can also find here and here also. Okay, as usual, you can draw a graph, path operation, define path by node. You can select both nodes. Then say okay. You can use any value. Okay, map onto path. Next, define path. First, we define the path where we want to find the result. So that is path. First, we define path. Then map onto path. which we want to find, which data we want to find out. So we can give any name. Then we want to find the temperature, nodal temperature. Sorry. So then say okay, the flat path item on graph. Flat path item on graph. We will give the name GG. We gave the name GG. So you can see here, it the graph shows distance versus temperature. Okay. So initially, at the distance 10, at the distance 0, the maximum temperature is 155. Instead of 175, it shows 155. So it will gradually reduce it. At the end, it will come to 75. Okay, clear. It shows, you can use this graph, you can find out the temperature at some distance. For example, I want to find 5 at the distance 5 at middle. What the temperature means? Almost around 95 degree. Okay. So this is as usual method. Now, we want to find, this is as usual method. So this is as usual method. But in transient, how it will significant in steady state means, in transient problem, you can see, for example, I want to find the temperature here with respect to time. For example, it shows, just a minute. For example, it shows the temperature here, 137. It means after 50 seconds, the temperature is 137. Are you able to follow me? After 50 seconds, the temperature is 137. But we want to find each and every 5 seconds. It also possible to find the temperature at every 5 seconds. First 5 seconds, what is the temperature? Second, 10 seconds, what is the temperature? 30 seconds, what is the temperature? No, 40 seconds, what is it? We can find 40 seconds, what is the temperature? Particular point, this point, okay? It is a max after 50 seconds, 137. Whereas, each and every step, you can find the result. How it means? You can go to time history post-processor, okay? You can go pick time history post-processor, data, air data, which we want to find out means nodal temperature, okay? Then you pick approximately here, okay? I already picked here, so you can pick approximately here. And say okay. Then this is graph. The signal graph data. You can see here. Graph data is there. You can pick the graph data. You can see now. Temperature versus value. Value at the particular area. The maximum temperature is 125 after 50 seconds. But 5 seconds 0. 5 seconds 12.5 centigrade. 25 seconds almost 60. Like that. So by using this graph at particular point, how the temperature will vary from each and every second, we have to find. Okay, so this is the transient thermal analysis. It is very, very useful in it is applicable in furnace, okay, in thermal plants and furnaces, even our designing of two-wheelers, automobile engines also. Okay, thank you. Thanks for giving this opportunity for our to me. I thanks once again to our HOD and our college. Thank you.